Yo, what's up, world? Welcome back to the Moving Forward Show, motherfuckers. It's good, man.
That's a fucking fact, but, you know, on some real serious shit, man, you know, it's fucked up that your own peoples won't see you, don't want to see you succeed, man.
We ain't even rich yet or out the hood yet, man. But, we still in the hood, man.
But we moving forward anyway. It doesn't matter, man.
Name of the show is Moving Forward. Fuck all you haters. Eat a dick, motherfucker.
Yes, sir.
Hey, man, what's going on? There's been a lot of shit going on in the hood, man. A lot of shit going on in the world, period, man.
Yeah, that's a fact. This fucking bitch lady.
Amber Geiger.
Get 10 years
race warrior.
For first degree murder, though. 10.
My thing is the compassion that we have with our oppressors, man.
Right. They combing her hair. They hugging her. Like, how you get all dazzled up to get sentenced? Like,
before the sentencing, and then we wonder why the outcome is the outcome. Because right. Look what we're doing.
That's
look
a
what
fact.
We doing. Know what I'm saying? You got the deceased brother hugging her, crying, saying they forgive her. That shit come from religion, man. That shit is like crazy, man. It's like mental illness, bro.
Yeah, I mean they do that. The religion based on their beliefs. Believe in, you know, because just forgiving them. You know what I mean? Like forgiving the person.
I guarantee if you go outside right now and kill a motherfucking white woman, you wouldn't get 10 years. You'll get forever in about 4 days.
40 more years.
Super fact.
Without a hesitation.
Super fact, man.
That and she was off duty with her uniform on, went in the house and did that. You know what I'm saying? So,
it's either my man was smashing that and she was tight,
right,
or something, man.
That's probably why the brother hugged her. Like, damn, you did that over the stick. Damn, stick was right.
Talking about how you accidentally go in somebody's house. We covered this on the show before, but how you accidentally go in someone's house thinking it's yours? How you do that?
Yeah,
and he had a whole red carpet though on the floor.
First, you got to walk up to the house, right? You definitely got to walk up to the house. So once you do that, then it's more so like, you know what your house looks like.
Facts.
Like, facts. You got to walk up to that shit.
It's crazy, man.
You know what I'm saying? But, you know, it is what it is.
That shit is foul, man.
No, matter of fact, it is what it is. Like, we tired of being the doormat. Right. You know what I mean? We tired of being the Negroes or the Black African American people being stepped on. Fuck that, man.
Shit,
it's too
wicked,
easy
man.
For them to do it. It was too easy to give 10 years for first degree murder. It was a young lady for a warning shot got 20 years.
Right.
It was a young man that got 45 years or 40 years for killing a police dog.
Yeah, that's foul.
That's fucked up.
So a dog.
A dog's life is worth more than a human's life. How
a
real
black
is that?
A black man's black woman's life was like we not worth shit.
That's a fact.
When do we wake up, man? When the fuck do we wake up, man? I guess our special guest is coming.
Yeah, our guest is here.
Finally in Shut the
out.
Building, man.
Shout out to Guttle.
BKG, man. What's up, nigga? I was tight for a minute. I'm like, what the fuck, yo? What's good?
Happy birthday, too.
Happy birthday, nigga. What's the deal? What's poppin'? What happened? It's all right. Sit your ass down, nigga. Huh?
What happened right now?
Oh,
I need to get dressed. I'm fucking eating with the...
It's all right, man. Put the
headphones
on, bro.
Put the headphones on, man.
Happy birthday, man. Take a shot with us, man. Take a shot with us. Yo, man. Yo, we recording, Qua? Yo, edit all that shit out, man.
Yo, here. Good looking, bro.
Happy birthday, my brother.
Thank you, bro. Motherfucking chain dickhead Mexican nigga, too.
What the fuck, man? Record that, though.
Good luck.
They don't need no pineapple. You do?
Yeah, I do.
You need pineapple, man.
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
What's the deal, shit, man?
What's up, man? Deal,
what's going
man?
On,
what's going
man?
On,
good to see you, man. Good to see you in here, man. This shit is a raw interview right now.
Raw
this
pulse.
This nigga just got pulled over coming to the fucking Moving Forward show, man.
Word, yeah, word. Man.
What's the
but
deal?
But he still made it here, though.
Still made it here on his fucking birthday, man. Yeah. What's going on, son? What's good, bro? Let's do it.
We're moving forward. Talk to me.
Yo, every time we're trying to get you, boy, it's like they ain't want you in the building with us, man.
I know, son. You heard him here, though, man.
No doubt, man.
What's going on, man? Shit. Where's the projects? What you
What's
working
on, man?
We're working on, well, next week, me and Skinny shooting a video to, what's that song called? How Would You Feel?
Yeah.
Shooting some shit to that. I got some shit in process.
Progress
with Busta Rhymes right Dope. Now.
Yeah.
Special, you know what I'm saying? So
shout out to Bust and Spesh, man.
Yeah,
shout out to Spesh, boy.
Yeah, you know, Spesh like pops to me. So, you know, we him and Bust been going at it every day, just figuring out this paperwork shit again and all that. That should be a fucking
It's a headache.
It'd be a science project in the beginning. I'm sure that all artists,
right.
you know what I'm saying, understand what I'm talking about as far as the percentages. And cause nigga don't know how much you going to blow or how much you not going to blow.
Right.
So a nigga want to make sure he got you
covered
locked and keyed just in case.
How many years you signing for?
We're going to do a three-year deal.
Three-year deal.
It's not bad.
Three-year deal with Conglomerate. Yeah, I'm already signed to Special Entertainment. And then we going to go to a major, like Atlantic or somebody.
So all right. I heard through the grapevine that you're trying to work with Dr. Dre. Is that true?
Yeah. Dr. Dre is definitely going to be part of that project. Or
That's
whatever.
Amazing.
A lot of the tracks that I did before I went to prison was from a producer that's in his camp.
Okay.
And his name is Focus.
Mm-hmm.
So Buster just actually told me the other night, like he ain't never told me in years, like you know what I'm saying. Even back then when he went down there, and we just just having a man to man. He like, yo, matter of fact, I'm lying. He called me like 5 a.m. I was with my bros and shit. That nigga like, yo, man, like I played this shit for Dre before.
Wow,
you know what I'm saying?
So he familiar with you?
Yeah, familiar with the voice.
Actually, right?
So I'm like, what? I'm like, you know, how was it? That nigga was like, son, them niggas went crazy. But I told him you was a problem.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Going in and out of jail. And so, you know what I'm saying? He was like, yo, listen, man, get his shit together. Then he found out I got locked up or whatever. But he know I'm home now and shit. So Bust said, do the paperwork with him. And I'm also trying to, do my own thing too as well. I'm not waiting on no man, but that's like the big epic dream that I'm,
bust
out and do right now, whatever. That's the major goal for me, where I want to be at the age I am, because I'm not young no more, where, like, I can't dance and, I'm just trying to get in the building.
Right.
And once the nigga in the building.
Yeah, you could do what you want to do. You could open the lane for young motherfuckers that's coming up under
East New York, man. We from Pink Isles. We born in poverty.
That's a fact, though.
Once we get neck and neck with these dudes that's cutting the checks and shit, and, I feel much better.
Right.
You know
I seen you online with Chris Gotti.
Yeah.
What's your relationship with him, man? How you meet him?
I met Chris Gotti back in the days, around 2003 with Just.
Right.
Just was managing me, Free Just. Just from Lil Just from Brookline.
Right.
And but how I got in the door was through Fee and Butter.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And at the time, I ain't gonna lie, that was
Freedom Both.
That was my first time actually recording around in a $1 million studio. We had the crack house and they was beefing at 50 at the time, like crazy. So the whole lockup thing was in process So a lot of things like went left or whatever with the label. They remember they ran in there, took all their money and And I got next to Chris. Chris was always the one that was around the street.
Right.
Gotti.
That's a fact.
Irva, He with the shits too, but nigga, I'll be around Jay and Beyonce.
Right,
like,
no doubt.
And Chris, the office was, now that I'm older, I was a young kid, then the office was just filled with street motherfuckers. Like, right. Just like
in and out.
That's a fact. Hell yeah. I remember those days.
Yeah, hell yeah. And you know what I mean? He just took a liking to me. He started taking me to the studio up there and, you know, Rule up there. I'm behind the same mic Rule and Ashanti record. I'm like, oh yeah, I'm
yeah, that shit motivates you like a motherfucker.
You know what I'm saying? One day I'ma just, you know what I mean, keep doing what I'm doing, even on a bread level, son, looking out for me on some, you know, just chill out for a minute. Going up to the office, son.
That's real
you
shit.
You know what I mean? For real.
Real shit.
That's a good dude, man. I got nothing but love for him.
Shout out to Chris Gotti.
Not too long ago on this show, we had somebody, an artist, another Busta artist by the name of Prayer on our show.
All right.
And
yo, I just asked him a question about you.
Yeah.
And his fucking answer was amazing, though. I tell you that. It was exceptional. Like, it was one of them shit to be like.
He was like, we heard, this is what we heard. You could clear it up. We heard Prayer came in. He started rapping, being all in pink houses, and you ain't know who he was. You wanted to know who he was, so you kind of like.
Rapping the hood. That's
who the fuck is this? Tell us what happened. Did that happen?
Yeah, that definitely happened. That I had to, you know. That's where I'm from. That's stomping ground. So, you know, and nobody trying to dial with no hood. You know what I mean?
Right.
It sound foolish, but you know, you repping now in these days. You repping is your storyline. That's
right,
what
right.
You know what I'm saying. So right. You know, when I first seen it, then you working with Bus and Bus know the storyline. So I'm just like.
You think he was trying to take your place or some shit? Like, yo, hold up. He fucking with Bus, he in pink houses.
I mean, at that time, Bus wasn't fucking with me no more. He wasn't, you know what I mean? I spoke to him in prison probably once or twice.
Okay.
So I'm home like, what the fuck this nigga trying to make another me? But
right.
Big, I don't know, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, you know, it was kind of like shocking or whatever, like to just take in, you know what I mean? And,
right.
And even back then, when I was getting money, you know, niggas wasn't paying my bills.
Right.
So in my mind, like, nigga can't be only so mad at a nigga. That's how I look at it. So mad at a person
right.
who got to survive and take care of their family. You know right. what I'm doing every day.
Right.
So, you know, you can't get so mad.
Right.
But you are investing mad money, too. So
right.
You do have a reason to get mad. And that was one of the reasons that he's really mad. He just
was
let
Busta
me know that,
investing
like,
the money or was it special? That was or both?
Busta.
Okay.
Yeah, he invested. He executive produced my album. He got the features. He
right.
got the beats. He got he did all the sounds. He
right.
did everything.
So your
he,
album is you have an album already that's
yeah,
cooked up,
a,
ready
I
to
got,
go.
I got an album that's cooked up, ready to go.
Wow.
I got a Brooklyn record. I got some shit with Mary. I got some shit with Busta. I got
some shit with Mary J. Blige.
Yeah, I got
wow.
some shit with M.O.P.
Mm.
I got a couple. I got a mean joint with Jeremiah. You know what I'm saying? All these shits were surprising songs to me because, like.
Are you doing these records and then leaving space for hooks?
Yeah, we doing. This is how I'm about to tell you right now
right.
how I work, how Bus work. You know what I mean?
Right.
I go and, you know what I mean? He'll just put the beat on, like, yo, you got something for that? And I spit, boom. And then he'd be like, all
right, right.
stop right here at 16.
Right.
And then like literally finish the same shit you was rapping when the beat come back on
right.
to the thing. So I'm doing it like that. We knocking shit out, boom, 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 and then, you know, I'm coming back and
hearing your finished project with the artist on it.
And then one day I'm coming back, yo, coming to the studio, then I come in and then Mary's on the hook. Then
wow.
you know what I'm saying, M.O.P. is on the remix and
wow.
you know what I mean? Yo, come he not never telling me nothing. We going to the clubs and you know what I mean? Just putting shit in the hard drive. I'm like, oh, that's my shit. Like, so you know, it's an amazing experience. I ain't gonna never lie. That's my shout out my big brother Busta.
Right.
That's my big brother.
No doubt.
You know what I mean? This big homie right there.
Now you said you from Pink Houses. There's
yeah.
another artist by the name of Uncle Murder from Pink Houses. What's your relationship with him?
I don't have a relationship with him.
Y'all don't. You'll never do a collab with a record with him.
Not right now. Not right now. I'm sure he feel the same way. Like you know. So, not right now. I wouldn't. You know what I mean? I'm not. You know. I see the nigga a lot. We. We always on the what up level
right.
or whatever. But you know, as far as the hood and. You know, at the end of the day, I'm. You know, I'm at a different caliber at it in the streets, and he had a different caliber at it in music.
Right.
So, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm trying to get where he's at, and he ain't trying to go back to where I am. Right.
But see,
so
we see got BKG. The thing is, right, leaving. When is it time to leave the streets alone?
Good one. I was coming up with that. That was a good one.
When is it time?
It's no time. It's no time. It's God time. It's just when you get a call in, especially when we come from, it's nothing around us. We from the bottom of the barrel of this whole poverty living, this whole nature living.
Right.
It don't get no worse than Cypress Pink houses on our end. Shout out to Linden, all of them, the creek everywhere. Right. But I'm talking about on some real project living growing up.
Nasty shit. Over there.
It's nasty, bro. Mm-hmm. Niggas who survive and even make it to the age something. I am to even right. to for real, like niggas, you know, they rap about it and fabricate it so much and raps that it's just a rap to some people, but to us, like, niggas is making it to 18. That shit is like,
right, that's why I'll be celebrating your birthday today.
That's a fact.
Take a shot from gutter, man. Happy birthday, because guess what? A lot of niggas ain't see that shit, man.
Good looking.
A lot of niggas ain't see that shit.
That's a fact, man. And I come from that environment and that, you know, that lane where I was born in the streets, and you know what I mean? No moms, no pops. I've been out there. I seen a lot of my friends die. I seen a lot of my friends in jail. You know what I'm saying? And shit like that. I just seen Uncle Murder post Debo too, free Debo. I fuck with Debo.
Right, Brown.
Know? Yeah, I think we always kept a little, you know what I mean, cordial because of that. You know what I'm saying? Not to say that I got, you know, he's older than me, and not to say that I got beef with the nigga, because, you know, what's beef? You know what I mean? Right. Like, but
killer.
Far as, you know, we ain't gonna sugar far as the young niggas, the drama and all that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I gotta watch out for myself. So by right. any means of that, I'm doing that.
And my thing is, like, when it comes to drama, right, in the hood, do you outgrow drama, or is it generational?
Not to cut nobody off, man. Like, I'm a little older than him, and we both come from the same projects.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't outgrow that shit. That shit travel, niggas inherited. It be niggas with beef that don't know why they got beef. Because right. they just chose to do something that they wanted right. to do. Whatever. You know what I'm saying? So
mm-hmm.
that shit, like, it travels, man. Like, when you get out of places, of course, when you meet face to face with just that person from that part of something, of course, y'all conversation may be different because right. of the type of time that niggas is on and what they trying to do. But when it all go down, they going for what they going for, and we going for what we going for.
That's a
and,
fact.
Yeah, that's a fact.
And that shit travel.
Mm-hmm.
Man, that shit, you know, it's I know beef that started in 95. Nigga, it's 2020.
And drama still going on.
You know what I'm saying? So, and everybody grew up into it. Like, you know, me, him, everybody grew up.
Like, and it's crazy, like, how, you know, like, the hood, like, yo, man, I find it to be the most dumbest thing in the world.
Mm-hmm.
What we beefing over us, numbers, 7 and 8, 5 and 6, or whatever, you know what I mean? Like, I ain't gonna lie, I'm a real nigga, bro.
Right.
What is a real nigga? I stand for something.
Right.
So, you know, I can't see a person who one day, if I'm at a distance, he'll take my life with a gun and then don't. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna definitely ask you, what's my beef with you? You heard?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna ask you, what's my beef with you? You know what I'm saying? You know, you got people who would blow at you. They don't even know what they blowing at you for.
Right. Like,
you know what I'm saying? So I want to know. I seen one of my ops somewhere like that. Yo, what's my problem with you? Like,
right.
Before we get it. Or whatever, like, what's up? Like, what did I do to you?
Right.
I want to know what I did to certain
to make you not like
that want to kill me. Like, mm-hmm. I understand if I robbed you or took something from you or you want to kill a nigga. You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? But if I never did nothing to you, never seen me, what's my beef with you?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I feel like that's the part of this whole black upcoming thing that makes us look terrible as men, as black people. That we out here killing each other for nothing. We could go kill. You could go kill somebody else that right. need to die.
Right.
You know what
I'm saying? A
couple
motherfuckers.
That's a fact.
Amber Geiger. She's one of them.
You know right. what I'm saying?
I wanted to ask you. How you feel about that 6ix9ine situation?
Dub.
It's a fucking dub.
That shit is fucked up, ain't it, man?
Yeah, that nigga in there telling on the lights. You know, the lights don't come on until 10 o'clock. Yeah. You know, I don't know what they doing, but the lights.
6ix9ine violated everything, bro.
Yeah.
And the funniest
it's so crazy
shit,
that
he going
to
come out
if
and still
he, they
be.
Seen mm-hmm. him trying to come out. You know what I mean? And he had his lane. His lane wasn't really, you know, he was talking to gangbang and shit. But if you really listen to it, it was for fucking white kids.
It was pop.
You know what I'm saying? So they, you know, as far as street shit, ain't nobody. Niggas ain't jack. Who you going to do a song with that's lit? Me? Cardi,
that's
all these niggas that's respecting the game and upholding that's that. You ain't gonna do that. You gonna probably have your own lane when you still touring and all of that. You know what I'm saying? You know what you're getting yourself into.
Yeah, he played himself.
You know what I mean?
He's a whole dub.
He played himself. I also seen your Soul Brooklyn verse.
Yeah, I'm feeling it.
I was waiting for the whole one.
I ain't gonna lie. He got a sneaker I know something about. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I can't wait to that.
What's the name of it?
Coughable Lung.
Yo, where that's at, man? I see your stories.
Cass ain't post my shit, though, man. You know, I've been jailing a long time.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I know niggas.
You know Cass from jail, nigga?
I never met him, but you know what I'm saying? My son Classic, you know what I mean?
Rest in peace, Classic.
And they co-defendants beefing. And I ain't blood. I ain't none of that. You know what I'm saying? But I'm East New York.
What was your relationship with Classic?
Classic was my man. That was my brother.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I got next to niggas to get money in the world.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I don't care. I'm going to send you my Soul Brooklyn. I'm in my hood.
That's a fact, though.
You know what I mean? I named Brooklyn Gutter. You ain't gonna never take that away from that or none of that.
That's
you know
a
what
fact.
Saying? I just did it to do it. That ain't gonna make my career or nothing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I love the support my whole area gave me.
Right.
My comments.
Right.
Big Fendi liked it. Spesh liked it. Bus liked it. You know what I mean?
You think it had
Lambo liked it. You know what I mean? Y'all liked it. Right. I'm good. That's all that matters. I'm thriving something positive.
You think it was something more deeper than the reason why he ain't posted?
Hell yeah. Of course.
Why? Say it.
Real shit.
I couldn't say because I never met him in jail. But you know, if you all right, so when Class was home, he was hanging with Spesh. He got around Spesh through me.
Right.
The alliance of us hanging out, getting money in, you know what I mean? Because I was a young nigga getting a bag.
We was out,
you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Do whatever we doing. I don't like to, you know what I'm saying? And it was understood. Ain't got to be explained.
That's
a fact. So, you know, I'm sure he heard the name, of course. And I was just with his code D. I even got pictures with him in the feds, my son Black O'Maco. That's his code D on the case that he did.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I was in there with Brash, his other man. He definitely know me. You know what I'm saying? We ain't gonna act like he don't. He definitely know me. But I don't know. Maybe it was too hard. Maybe he was like, man, this nigga.
I don't like that.
This shit is. I can't. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. I gotta find out whenever I bump into him.
Cass doing relatively well as an artist, as a new artist. I see he hungry. I see that he's steady working.
Mm-hmm,
I respect his grind like a motherfucker.
I definitely respect what he did for Brooklyn. I respect the whole, you know what I'm saying? But I'm not blood. I'm not your Cody.
Right.
So if you got any kind of issue, you should let it go.
That's a fact.
I wasn't, you know what I mean? I'm not gangbanging whatever it is to make you, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? And that's about it.
I think it'd be more about relationships. Like once y'all get in the same room together and y'all bill.
Yeah,
it'll probably be a different energy.
Yeah,
I think so too. I think that when people get around each other, the energy nigga give off, you gonna respond to it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, I think that'd be less necessary.
And then I see him. You know, he real.
Oh shit! My bad.
I see he real. You know, he fuck with murder.
Right.
So you know, I don't know if they
in cahoots.
I don't know, you know what I mean? I'm just doing me, man. It could be tons of shit. I don't know.
Right.
You know what I mean? But I'm doing me. That's it. I'm out of the feds. I'm fresh home. You know what I mean?
Continue.
Birthday today, man. Happy birthday once again.
Good luck.
Also,
I made it.
You made it, you know, like a motherfucker.
I lost people this year. I lost motherfuckers to sickness. I lost niggas to bullets. I lost niggas to natural just dying. I lost niggas. I lost niggas. Well, and females. You know what I'm saying?
Rest in peace, Ball.
Talking about
rest
losing
in peace,
niggas.
Ball, Reva.
Talking about losing niggas, I lost motherfuckers that's alive. Because I had to cut a couple niggas off, man.
Sometimes you got to do that, though.
Like that.
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to do that. Sometimes you got to cut ties with shit. You know what I'm saying? And that's just that. You know what I mean? Ain't no love lost, man. See you on top, man.
Oh, yeah.
And we pray for you in your endeavors. You know what I mean? Whatever.
Right.
But
well, you ready to spit these bars, bro?
Yeah, I'll definitely give y'all some.
You
got
to give us something to this, man. I'm going to see how you feel this beat first, man.
Yeah, let me hear.
I need to hear some shit, man. All
right.
Hold on. Let that go. Here we go. Hear something to this, man. Moving forward.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I'm gonna let that drink dry real quick.
Yeah.
Brooklyn.
Let's go, Gutter.
Uh-huh.
BK Gutter for y'all.
Yeah. It's that Brooklyn shit right here.
East
Yo.
New York, PH, nigga.
The presidential rollie came with the blackface, I call it Obama. Black tape on the 40 or the old llama. The max spray, I want no drama. When I spit a hot nine, they gon' drop bombs, Osama. I learned the game from my old Palmer. He said patience is the key and got rich cause he's a slow grinder. I have my nigga CeeLo go find ya and hop out of the six right before he 4-5 ya. I keep niggas at bay, I'm like Jay, play the cuts all year, keep giving ya yay. Yeah, I'm nice, but I'm nicer. Fight, I would knife ya. Your wife, I could pipe. Take out of town the whole shit like a diaper. My brother made the board, he was a lifer. When he came home, I got hyper. Next year, I'll be on the cypher. And some ball mains that I got from a chick cause of a swiper. The kid flaws, move snow, the wrist frost. Let's not forget, thick Cuban, big cross. Panamera, turbo, big Porsche. Sipping Bel Air, I'm trying to get it like Rick Ross. Driver, hit your sweater to get the cheddar. I'm getting better, nigga want it, then it's whatever. The fifth car, I get guap. Yo, that's my only concern in the tub, rubbing on thick thoughts. I spit hot, he spit hot. I've been a shooter in the game, and for my team, I hit shots. But really, I'm like sinners. I get blocks and try not to be like doors and get knocked.
Woo.
I cook up in big pots. I'm about to blow. This the same feeling that big got before the stardom. Before more money, more problems. I'll kick in your door, waving the 4-4. Before the tours, move you in the fourth floor. Yeah, I off raw just to get me an offshore. I got your bitch on the knees and a raw sore. Knees bruised. Who's hotter than these dudes?
Yeah.
Well, hit my line if you need food. I'm done.
Yeah.
Let's go, Cutter. Woo! Yo, I'm ending it off there. I don't even want to talk no more.
Yo, man, you burnt it down. Yo, don't come to this motherfucking podcast if you don't want to spit.
Yeah.
That's a fact.
If you're not spitting bars, shout out the Cashmere, shout out the Gutter. Y'all both burnt this shit down.
Good looking, bro.
Good looking. Shout out to Donique. Shout out to Jake J.
Shout out to Move Forward.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a fact,
we
man.
Moving forward,
we
man.
Moving forward. Moving forward, man.
We uplifting each other in the hood, man. That's what we doing, man.
That's
we
a fact, man.
I know some real shit, man. I could be the toughest nigga in the world, man. Like we got to open up our minds where we live in. And niggas need to stop killing each other over nothing, man.
And that's the moral of this whole motherfucking podcast.
That's a
man.
Fact, man.
We the only area where a nigga ain't get on and take care of the hood and uplift your community. Like, you know what I'm saying? Shit like that. Like, who? When I get on, I got my son and my wife. That's it. All my niggas in the streets with him. They good.
Right.
My wife a teacher. She good. We good.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, bro. I feel like when I need to uplift my community, bro.
Right. We all we got, man. Rather you rapping, doing fucking podcasts, but it's hard when you trying to come up and you got these motherfuckers just clawing you back down.
That's a fact. That's why motherfucker gotta motherfucking just put everything.
Crabs in the barrel.
You know, you got to put your mindset on one thing, one goal, and we can't let nothing stop us. We can't let nothing get in between of that.
Right.
You know what I mean? You got to basically look insane when you got that mission, man. Look right. at the, some of the people that's built, rich motherfuckers. Them niggas don't get married until years later.
Facts.
They don't deal with the headache. They don't have, they cut motherfuckers on. You know
they
what I mean?
They cut their own family
when,
off,
when
bro.
When you got that vision, when you got it in your mind, and I don't care if every day, you know what I'm saying, you might not see the progress that you think you're seeing. But, nigga, the universe is spinning and you're getting closer to that. If
that's
it's in
fact.
Your mind, and you already could feel it and touch it, like, before I get a BM, before I get anything. I already got that in my mind that that's
right.
what I'm going to
You could
have.
Taste that shit.
You know what I'm saying? I could taste. I could feel myself uplifting my communities with my brothers.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Any way we can do, man.
Right.
Like, we need to start Thanksgiving, school clothes, Christmas.
Right.
Any little thing. We waste money on a bunch of other shit that's bullshit.
Niggas throw 50 and then niggas throw 10, 20 bands in clubs. Why can't we use this same
Come
money
on,
that
man.
You're throwing in the strip club for something
Come
that's
on.
Going to uplift the community
on,
for
man.
A better cause?
Uplift
for
our
a
community.
Better cause.
Nobody never did it, man. Only thing that came from there is
violence,
guns, drugs, jail, and the niggas who maybe would have got on through grinding got clipped off somewhere in the path. And
right.
the nigga that is on in the area ain't supporting the hood.
They don't give a fuck about the hood, but then you got to think about it.
You know what I mean?
As this. The ones that care about the hood take them down.
That's what I'm saying. And niggas ain't saying give your bag to the hood and eat and share. I'm going to show niggas. That's what I'm going to do. I don't even want to talk about it. I'm going to show niggas, you know what I'm saying? And I don't even want to speak it out and make niggas, damn, he ain't right. Let me just do it before. You know what I mean? That's
mm-hmm.
going to be my, that's what's in my heart
right.
that I'm going to do. For my people, and I ain't scared, bro. I go, I stand on any corner, I stand in front of any building. I'm not scared to die. I'm not scared of no bullets. I'm not scared of nothing.
Right.
You heard, bro? I go anywhere. I'm not afraid of you. I'm not afraid of nothing.
That's what
was brought on to me. That's what I was raised.
No
I'm not
doubt.
Afraid of anything.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? We ain't submitting. We ain't doing none of that, nigga.
No doubt.
You get me locked up. I don't care what you heard. Oh, yeah, nigga might be telling all this or this or that, nigga. I was in the maximum federal facility with
no
Jimmy
doubt.
Henchman World, fucking Ab, where everybody running at. You
right.
know what I mean? Some niggas good, some niggas not. But you know, Tone Wolverine everywhere.
Right.
Tuquan, I mean, I was in there. You know what I mean?
No doubt. No
so,
doubt. Real
you know,
shit.
My shit is valid, man. You know what I mean? And I appreciate for coming up and all that. You know what I mean? I like
Can't
that.
Appreciate
I like that
you
beat.
Here, man.
I love that beat you put on.
Yeah,
you
I told
heard?
You, man. Yeah. I knew you was going to body that shit.
Yeah, I've been listening to it for I've been hearing
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that Drake
I'm
and fucking
like,
Rick Ross. That shit is fire.
Son, word of mother. I was listening to it, I think, yesterday. Rob pulled up in the car. I was like, yo, that fucking beat is hard.
Yeah, that shit fire. I was like, woo.
I was like, yo.
But you ate that shit.
Yeah,
that
I kind of slipped up a
crazy.
Little bit.
Nah. You fucked that one up.
It's all right if I had that little slip up, but the first 30 bars was retarded.
Yeah, I was bugging for a minute. I said, damn, hold up.
You know what I'm saying?
Hold up.
Oh, yeah. So
now, we appreciate
you
for coming
through,
man.
Next week, well, actually, me and my brother, my little brother Rocky, we next weekend, we doing something like a video birthday celebration and shit already paid for and all that. I'm
right.
saying y'all where I'm at.
Yeah.
We could continue this over there, too.
That's a fact, though.
You know
though.
What I mean?
Right.
And this shit or whatever, out of the niggas already...
Yeah,
it's my joint. It's like a club time. I'm gonna send you that shit. Bottles right. gonna be like 100 bottles there, man.
Nah, we gonna be there.
Nah, the video.
Yeah, I'm gonna be there.
We gonna be there, man.
Yeah,
we gonna be there. Celebration, man. It's time to celebrate life.
Yeah.
Celebrate success.
Yeah.
All motherfucking positive energy. If you're
That's
not moving forward, where the fuck are you going? And I just want to end the shit like that, man.
No, moving forward.
Shout out
BKG.
To Lambo. Shout out BKG.
Got it. East New York. Pink House.
Cyprus,
you know what I mean?
The whole East, man. Star
the whole
right.
East.
We in the building, man.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Yeah.
One. Fuck you haters.
Wow.